Hi everyone, welcome to our new video. Today we're gonna look into something very interesting. Have you ever seen like some people using Ctrl Linux, but they use the taskbar like the one in Windows, but you don't know how to do it, and it's really more interesting than the one in Kali, because most of you guys, or most of us, we grew up using Windows machines. So a person always is gonna be happy to use something which he's familiar with than learning something new. So you can see how beautiful the taskbar is. I set up the color I wanted. I put it here, it was this side, and also I can put it here, I can put it here. These are the one of the things we need to do. Trash is here, all your stuff, you put them here. You can see everything. If I want this, I just click here instead of going to the to the left. It looks even a little bit normal if you put it here, because even somebody who doesn't know computers, he can recognize that there's something which is going on here, which is good. So this looks like the Windows button here, you can see, and these are the Windows, like as we say, could look like the Windows icons. So I opened that and it went to the second screen, so I'm coming, bring it here. You can stop doing your typing in here if you want to do so. You can say maybe hi, whatever you wanna do here. You can save as you want, so I'm gonna cancel this. I said don't save. Then we're gonna go into our tutorial to see what to do. What you're gonna do, you click here and you say settings, setting, once you say settings, you look for extension, extension, search here and say extension. You can't see it, it's fine. There, we don't worry yourself, we're gonna get it. You can just put in here extension. Once you click extension, click on extensions here. You can see here, that's when I wanna make the screen a little bit half, not full of this, because you won't see what's going on. So you can see here, that's when they talk about the dock. When you see the dock, you switch off, it disappears. Switch on, it appears, reappears. Then there's settings here, whereby you're gonna do what? You're gonna play here with the left. You can see it come to the left, bottom comes back to the bottom, top it comes to the top the way you want, and right it comes to the right. Then still you can say standard or secondary monitor. If you say standard, it's gonna only show everyone. Then if you can say choose this, also you're gonna say different results. So here on this monitor standard, on the second monitor it disappears and come back. I'm gonna leave it by the bottom as what we wanted. Intelligence auto hide, if you do that, then it's gonna be hiding itself wherever you do something. So intelligence auto hide, it can hide itself, but it does that on the second screen. If you want to do that also, you can look into that. So I switch that off because I don't want it to auto hide. You can also click on here. Once you do that, you can select and say enable full screen mode, push to show required pressure to show the dock. So you can say enable full screen. If you want to do that, you can do that. If you don't want, you can also still leave it there. Dodge windows, show the dock when it doesn't obstruct application windows. You can so show that, or you can do that. You can see when you do that, it disappears. When I come here, mouse roll off, it comes back. But I wanna leave it like that. You say all windows, you can click that, all windows, only focused applications windows, only maximum windows. You can leave on here, focus what application, that's what I did. Animate duration, you can put this 2 seconds, whatever, I think so. Hide timeout. Also, this is something you can do that. Pressure threshold, you can set that if you want to do that. Then you can reset also to default. If I reset to default, what am I gonna see? You can see nothing much is being put here. You go here and cancel. You saw where we're here. So we move from there. We can say panel mode. We can click panel mode. Once you click panel mode, you can see that we have resized our taskbar to be something tiny. So you can also, okay, if you click here, it does the full panel. If you click here, it gives you a chance to give it how big you want it to be. You can see, you can make it smaller. You can make it maybe until there. You can see how beautiful it is. Okay, so once you do that, if you do this also, becomes bigger, and they become bigger and bigger, to the extent that they get even hidden because they are too big. So you can, if you leave them there and push this here, you can see you can have a big huge taskbar. So you can see all those things are good. So if you do this, you can see your taskbar icons are bigger, your taskbar, everything is big. So you can do everything according to what you need to see. So if you have eyes with eye problems, you can make them bigger or smaller, depending if you can see small objects or if you can see big objects. So that's gonna be on you. So go to launchers. You can also click on launchers, show favorite applications. This is the launcher anyway. You can click there. They don't show them, or you show them. Show running applications, show open. You can click that, and also you can click that, whatever you want to do. Isolate workspace, you can click that if you want to do, or you can leave it. Isolate monitors, you can click that, or you can click that. So whatever you want to do, that can do. Show applications on icon. So this, if disabled, these settings are accessible from Gnome Tweak tool or the extension website. Okay, so move the application button at the beginning of the dock. Look, okay, if you say at the beginning of the dock, what does it mean? Does it mean here? Okay, so what does it mean? Let's go do that, and we want to make these a little bit smaller, and make them smaller. So now we can't see it here anymore, maybe because the icons are big. It disappeared for sure. So since it disappeared, what we're gonna do, we're gonna show the panel, and we move it that way. We go back to launcher and bring it back. Our application, what settings it should be there. If it doesn't show, then unmute. Okay, we're there on that. Isolate workspace. Okay, show up favorite application, whatever. If you take them to come back, show this comes back. Okay, comes back. Okay, you can see your disk here. Okay, there are a lot of things to play with. Show application icons. Okay, okay, you come to behaviors here, and you say click action, circle through window, minimize or overview, launch instance, minimize, erase, whatever you want to choose here. If you do this, use keyboard shortcuts to activate apps if you want to do that. Appearance, it comes here. You see, this is the appearance we chose. You can say I need this color, then you select, look at the taskbar, it's gonna change the color, and come back and click here and select that. Maybe I want green to be what I wanna use. I can click black if I want to, and I select that, then it's gonna look a little bit black. Whatever color I choose to use, a Car Linux is gonna give it to me. So I wanna be with that color, so that color is gonna work for me. Use built-in themes if you want to, then it's gonna go away and give you the default one. So, but we don't want to default one, we want to use that. Guys, I think that's enough for now, and we've done a lot. You've seen how to put your taskbar down here, and it looks like Windows exactly. Thanks for watching, guys. Please don't forget to subscribe. We'll see you in the next video.